If you're looking to decrease your ankle pain, increase your ankle mobility, and increase your ankle strength, then ladies and gentlemen, this is the video for you.
Young visionary, and I don't know where I am. I'm running blindfolded like I ain't got a plan. You either steady living life or you afraid to die. But if you don't take that leap, how you know that you can't fly? So I'm just steady taking chances and I do this shit a lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we get started, make sure that you like this video, make sure that you subscribe to the channel, click the bell so that you never miss another video, and comment jump down below in the comment section if you want a free bodyweight vertical jump training program that will help you dunk on anybody who is standing in the lane. Today's question is from Ruben Desunik Van Capel. Ruben Desunik Van Capel says, video on ankle pain slash mobility. So today I'm going to give you a full routine on how to decrease your ankle pain, how to increase your ankle mobility, and how to increase your ankle strength so that you never have pain again. Let's get started. All right, ladies and gents, here we have our routine to decrease ankle pain, increase ankle strength, and increase ankle mobility. If you have weak ankles, then all that you have to do is strengthen your ankles. And if you have pain in your ankles while playing sports or just walking up and down stairs or just living everyday life, then what you need to do is strengthen your ankles so that that pain goes away forever. And if you have tight ankles, what you need to do is ankle mobility. So we're gonna go through some mobility here. We're gonna go through some strength and mobility. This is one giant routine that you should follow if you want the most results. You should follow all 10 of these exercises. And I promise it's not that long of a routine. Seems like it. But if you just wanted to do one or the other on a certain day, then you could do that as well. Or if you wanted to pick and choose from these exercises, you can do that as well. So number one is the stick drill. And for the stick drill, you're going to get any sort of stick. You're either going to get a broomstick or you're going to get an easy bar. You're going to go into your grandpa's backyard and break a branch off of his tree, but you need some sort of stick. You're going to put it behind your knees and you're going to use this for myofascial release of your calves and to stretch the tops of your ankles. So what you're going to do is start at the very top behind your knees, and then you're going to press down onto your calf with the stick for about 10 seconds. After you press down for 10 seconds, then you roll the stick a little bit lower, press down for 10 seconds, roll the stick lower, press down 10 seconds, and you roll the stick all the way down until you get to your Achilles. And then for my Achilles, what I like to do is roll it out a little bit on my Achilles. So it's myofascial release. It's like foam rolling for the back of your calves while at the same time stretching the tops of your ankles, which is very important for ankle mobility on the top portion. So that's the stick drill. You're gonna do 10 seconds and then move down. 10 seconds, move down, 10 seconds, move down until you get from the top of your leg behind your knee down to the bottom near your Achilles. The second exercise is ankle pumps. After you do this stick drill, the tops of your feet and your ankles are going to feel pretty tight. They're gonna feel like you need to loosen them up, and that is what we want. So we're gonna give them what they want. We are going to loosen them up with ankle pumps. So for ankle pumps, all that you're doing is pushing your toes all the way forward and then bringing your toes all the way back to you. So you're gonna do 15 forward and 15 backwards. The third mobility exercise we have are ankle circles. Just like the ankle pumps, we are just loosening up our ankles and getting them ready to go for the rest of these exercises. So for the ankle circles, you're basically going to spin your ankle in the biggest circle you can, 15 reps in each direction for each ankle. So right after the ankle pumps, we're going forward and back. Then we do the ankle circles, 15 reps each direction. Exercise number four is standing dorsiflexion pumps. And for this one, you're going to put your hands against the wall and you are going to pass your knee over your toe as far as you can go while keeping your heel on the ground. So you are really stretching that ankle, the back of the ankle, and working on your ankle dorsiflexion. So what you're going to do is 10 reps, you do 10 pumps, and then you do a 30 second hold and you stretch for that 30 seconds at the end. Then you switch legs, 10 pumps, and then a 30 second hold. But that's exercise number four. Exercise number five is weighted dorsiflexion. So you're gonna be doing the same thing, 10 reps, plus a 30-second hold at the end each leg, but you're going to be on the ground and you are going to have a weight, whether it's a dumbbell or a plate or your grandmother's coffee pot, whatever you have, put it on your knee and do 10 pumps plus a 30-second hold with a weight on your knee. This is really going to stretch your ankles and really improve your dorsiflexion and your mobility. So that's number five. This is the mobility section. Okay, this is for strictly mobility. But so if you just want to improve your mobility, you can do this, but I highly recommend that you do the strength plus the mobility section as well. This section is more important than this section. So if you're going to pick one or the other, I would 100% pick the strength plus mobility, because this just has mobility, obviously. This has mobility, but it also will help you strengthen your ankles, which will get rid of that pain and get rid of the weak ankles. Exercise number six is an inversion eversion drill. So what you're going to do is sit down on your butt. You're going to put your hands on the ground. You're going to put your feet on the ground. Then you're going to lift your butt up and you're going to do a hip swivel going back and forth, dropping your knees to the ground each direction. So your ankles, to be strong, your ankles aren't just meant to go forward and backwards. Your ankles also need to be strong going side to side, so that if you ever roll your ankle in basketball or you land on somebody's foot once you're going for a rebound, your ankles don't crumble on you like your grandmother's cookies. So inversion eversion drill, you're going to do 10 each direction, and this is going to help with that ankle mobility side to side, but also it's going to strengthen your ankles side to side. So this one is very important. Exercise number seven is the four direction drill. Now the four direction drill requires a mini band. So if you want a mini band, I will link it down below in the description. If you don't have a mini band and you wanted to skip this one, that is okay. It's obviously going to be better if you do this, but if you don't do this, the rest of them will be enough to strengthen your ankles and give you that ankle mobility. So you're basically going to move your ankles in each direction. You're gonna move it forward, you're gonna move it backwards, and you're gonna move it to each side. When you move it forward, you're going to be using the mini band as resistance. Same thing when you move it backwards, and same thing when you move it to each side. So you're basically fighting against the resistance of the mini band, going slow and controlled with your ankles so that you can build them up and make them stronger so that you don't have that ankle pain anymore. So with the four directions drill, you're going to do 10 reps each direction. And I will talk about the sets at the end of all of this, because I haven't been telling you how many sets to do. So that's the four direction drill. Number eight is ankle reaches. This is probably my favorite. I like this one the most, because ankle reaches, you're basically doing a dorsiflexion drill, but you aren't using a wall to hold you. You are putting your toe on a line, then you put your heel on the line, and you reach as far as possible with that opposite foot, touching your heel to the ground, and you're working on your ankle dorsiflexion, but you're strengthening it all the way through, and then you're bringing it back. So you must improve your ankle strength while you're doing this. You're not holding a wall and just practicing pushing farther and farther to stretch your ankle. You really need to use the muscles in your ankle to bring yourself back, which increases the strength of your ankle. So I really like this one. You're gonna do 10 each leg of the ankle reaches. Next we have number nine, which is tibialis raises. And listen, for the rest of these, I want you to have your shoes off. You want to have your shoes off when you are doing all of these drills and all of these exercises. You don't want your shoes on, especially if you have basketball shoes, because it is going to create a support for you, and you're not going to be able to get much stronger if that ankle is supporting you. Imagine if you did all these in an ankle brace or in shoes that come all the way up and wrap around your ankle. You're not really getting that strength, because you want to expose your ankle, give it bare feet so that it has nowhere to hide, so that we reveal the truth of how weak our ankles actually are with bare feet, so that we can get them stronger. So for tibialis raises, you want to do 25 reps each. But what I was getting at with the whole thing about your shoes off is, for these, you either want to have a pad under your foot, like a yoga mat, or you want to put your shoes on, because if you just do this on a hardwood floor, it's probably going to hurt your heels. So either put shoes on for this one or put a mat under your feet. Last but not least, we have calf raises. For calf raises, so many people do these wrong. And you're like, everybody knows calf raises. How can we do these wrong? If you are going quickly on calf raises. Unless you're doing ankle bounces or pogo jumps or you're jumping rope, you don't want to do these quickly, especially if you have weak ankles or you have Achilles tendonitis. You do not want to go quickly with these. You want to go slow on calf raises, going slow on the way down, holding it, pausing for 2 seconds, and then going slow and controlled on the way up, pausing for 2 seconds. So pause at the top for 2 seconds, pause at the bottom for 2 seconds, and go slow and controlled through the entire range of motion. So if you want to start with 2 feet, you can do 2 feet calf raises. I would do 20 reps. If you're gonna do 1 foot calf raises, which is obviously harder, then I would do 10 reps each leg. So there you go. There's all 10 exercises to decrease your pain, increase your strength, and increase your ankle mobility. So how many sets should you do for each of these? This is why I didn't say before. If you want to get the maximum amount of strength, if you want to decrease your pain as much as possible, get the most mobility you can, I would do 3 sets of all of these exercises. If your ankles are really bad, if they are very weak, if they are very tight, I would do 3 sets of all of these at least at first. You don't have to continue doing 3 sets for the rest of your life because listen, if you do this 3 times through, it's going to take a decent amount of time. So maybe for the first week, go through 3 sets of all of these. Okay, then once you get to the second week, I would go through 2 sets of all of these because your ankles are going to be getting stronger, they're going to be getting looser, and you don't need as much stimulus as you did in the beginning. You just need to get that momentum going, and then you can pretty much just maintain with this by doing 2 sets. So after you do 2 sets, from the third week on, just do 1 set of these, 1 set of these, but then do 2 sets of these. And I would do it 2 to 3 times per week. And then you could do that from there on out and you will never have ankle pain again. You will always have loose ankles that are strong. This has been Nathaniel Morton with how to decrease your ankle pain, increase your ankle mobility, and increase your ankle strength in the full routine to do exactly that. Like this video if you like it, subscribe to the channel, click the bell if you have not already. Leave your questions down below if you want me to answer your question on a video just like this. Comment jump down below if you want a free vertical jump training program to dunk on anybody standing in the lane. And remember that knowledge is not power. Knowledge is only potential power until you take action on what you know. Action is the way that you change your life. You gotta go out and do it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Young visionary, and I don't know where I am. I'm running blindfolded.